LYNEports is an advanced air mobility planning solution. It enables ground and airspace integration of eVTOL and drones with a simple and user-friendly geospatial software. So let's create a project in just a few minutes. The first thing we need to do is to identify a site. You can do so by clicking on the top left plus icon. I already have a location in mind somewhere in New York, so I am just going to type in New York City. I am interested in this site right here. Now we want to open the site location on the projects page. So we double click on it to add it here. We give it a name. And there we go. We can already see the Vertiport landing site on the location we've selected. The next thing we need to do is to choose an aircraft and the regulatory framework. We click on Calculate to refresh the page, and I am ready to start working on the infrastructure. So what we want to do is to add 3 parking stands and a terminal. We click on Calculate to refresh again, and there it is. We're also going to adjust the terminal width and length. Great, now I just need to adjust the Vertiport by rotating and moving it. Here, we are going to add the OLS and the flight slopes. So we click on Obstacle Limitation Surface, and we also want to activate the Vertiport Reference Protractor. This will help us understand the rotation of the flight slope and the flight paths. We can see that flight number 1 is colliding with 2 towers. We need to rotate it in a direction that is free of obstacles. We can zoom out a little bit to get a broader view and double check there are no obstacles in the way of these flight slopes. Now that we have our basic Vertiport ready, first let's turn off the flight slopes and the terminal, and let's upload our own model. We click on the Upload OBJ GLTF Models, and there it is. We need to align it a little bit better by clicking on the Align View to North and select the Move menu. We're also going to rotate it. Once you're done, make sure you select the No Objects to Move to lock it. You can now turn on the flight paths again to double check there are no obstacles. If everything is okay, just hit save and just push the model so it will update in the project planning page. And now if we go back to our projects, we will see our cool Vertiport project right here. To visualize that network, we need to click on the network icon. Add your network distance, and that will create your network. You can adjust the network distance and also adjust the network height. And you can also increase the distance to include vertiports that are further away. And that's it. We've just planned a vertiport in less than 5 minutes. Make sure you check our tutorials to learn more details about specific tools. Thank you.